although this was concerned, because as if one grabs me here, this is his power. He's here, he's going to use like his abs and his legs and his weight to drive me back, his strength, push, yeah? Okay, pull back with all sorts of other things like headbutting you. We're not worried about that for now. We're going to disrupt his energy. So we can now ask from push, disrupt his energy, look. It's hard to push it, because I'm messing his energy and I'm disrupting it, yes? Let's get that in our heads first before we do anything else with him, yeah? Under the radial nerve coming up across the top here, yeah? So you might be able to get a double nerve strike on this, not strike, but grab. One is with that central finger into the channel that the ulnar nerve runs in, and the thumb on top where the radial nerve comes across. Now Sam's a tough old boy, he's not going to really bother these too much. But rather than just grabbing any old work, you see, grab any old work. That finger, ulnar nerve channel, top finger, radial nerve on top, and push like this. Also, instead of just lifting, squeeze in very slightly, and then push in. So you're making a simple technique a little more effective. Miss this, good. I go for the slight further. Now, the final curve with this, at the flat of the hand, if you start using sort of uptake, this can be quite damaging to your nerves, yeah? You've got the muscle nerves with up your arm, but the ones that count, radial nerve comes down here, we use it a lot for striking, yeah? Median nerve comes down the inside, more relevant these type of things, yeah? You've even got one ulnar nerve goes in that little channel. It's on your funny bone, yeah? That's the ulnar nerve, but it's one of the longest unprotected nerves in the body, the ulnar nerve, yes? So I mentioned all that just so that when you come here, you don't have bruising nerves, yeah? And so you flat your hand a little bit, please, while you're training. Flat your hand, watch me.
Yes.
Yeah, see disruption, don't wait for it to disrupt. Maybe you can disrupt it here, can you see, get over it? If you get early on it, it's not such a problem. If you're on it late, you can be, yeah? So let's start with a simple disruption. You see the arm, rail is before it's going anywhere, yes? As I get in, yeah? Also, look, with this particular technique, he's expanding, isn't he? He's vulnerable for these shots. If you leave that too long, he's starting to compress, that's on you, and he's tensing up as well, yes? So he needs a bit of reaction training, looking for those body signals. But as it's just starting to come out, I can tell you now, he can't really get any oomph in that kick. So I just want to just catch him on that arm, yeah? Now his hands will be up, so you really want your hands up. What you don't want to be is in Mike's perfect target zone, which I imagine is about there, yes? If I get outside it, it's difficult. And if I get inside it, it's difficult. It's just when you're spot on that it's a dangerous kick, yes? So disrupt it, either by getting outside, best way of disrupting it is moving on it. Getting outside of it is an avoidance technique rather than a disruption technique. And we're trying disruption techniques. Often when you're sparring, you can like jump on him as a kid. And he'll like bounce off, because all his kick dynamics will be wrong by shortening the distance. Hope you enjoyed our video. There's more information on our website, www.goju.co.uk.